Hi everybody, my name is Cedric Scheerlinck, and welcome to my talk. So here are our final results. Videos reconstructed using an event camera. Cool, so how did we get here? First I'll explain what is an event camera. On the left you see a normal frame-based camera, and on the right, the output of the event camera. The event camera only outputs brightness changes. So when the brightness increases, it will output a positive event, and if the brightness decreases, you'll get a negative event. And at the pixels where the brightness is constant, there are no events. So the aim of our work was to take this sparse event data and to reconstruct a full brightness image. And so on the left, we see that we discretize the events into a space-time voxel grid. And then we use a very lightweight, recurrent, fully convolutional neural network. And you can see it's a very small network. There are only a few layers. We have convolutional gated recurrent units and residual blocks. And the output of that network is an image. And so with a sequence of inputs, we can get a sequence of images as a video output. Cool. So compared to the previous state of the art, our method is much more lightweight. So it runs 3 times faster on a modern GPU and 4 times faster on a CPU. It uses 10 times less floating point operations. That means we're much, much more computationally efficient. And interestingly, we actually achieve this with a very small neural network, 280 times fewer parameters. That means our network has only 0.4% the number of parameters as the previous method. And all of this while achieving quite a similar accuracy. So it gives a hint that the required capacity of the network is much smaller than we initially thought. And so to demonstrate our results, I'll show some example sequences. So on the left will be the previous state of the art E2D, and on the right is our method. And so these are some high-speed sequences being captured through the event camera. And you can see that the quality of the images is very similar. That's me popping a word with them. And I'll show some more results from a different data set. And just again to show that we get quite a similar image quality, but our method is much faster and much more computationally efficient.